Another election official from Brooklyn is clearing her desk. The city's Board of Elections voted to suspend without pay Betty Ann Canizio, the deputy chief clerk at the Brooklyn Elections Office. The vote was taken on Tuesday, but was publicly announced at the board's meeting 2 days later.
There is a lot of information to go through post-election with respect to all of the details that led up to the voters that were purged. And we want to make sure that when we take full and final action, that it's done based on all the facts and done appropriately.
Shortly after the April 19th primary, the board's top official in Brooklyn was temporarily removed from her post, suspended without pay as well, as questions mounted about why some 120,000 voters in Brooklyn had been stripped from the voter rolls. Many Brooklyn residents who thought they were registered showed up to vote, only to find their names were not on the list. State Attorney General Eric Schneiderman is investigating. City Controller Scott Stringer has also launched his own probe.
I think what we're going to find is that a lot of these people that were purged aren't around anymore.
To prevent something like that from happening again, the City Council is calling on Albany lawmakers to allow same-day voter registration. Resolutions passed by the council on Thursday advocate for no-excuse absentee voting and would allow people to register with a party up to 10 days before an election.
For me personally, voter empowerment and barriers to registration has been something I've been working on for nearly a decade. In fact, it's one of the issues that brought me into government.
Meanwhile, the city's Board of Elections failed to accomplish what it set out to do at its Thursday meeting, certify the citywide results from last month's primary. That had to be postponed when officials from the Manhattan office did not show up for the meeting. In Lower Manhattan, Grace Rao, New York 1.